Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, I'm going to show you two of the template settings which are going to help you keep your information more organized and easy to find inside of Dashpivot. Those settings are the form thumbnail settings and the form sorting settings. Now, first of all, the form thumbnail settings. What I mean by this is that each of these square boxes that you see here represents a form that is being filled out, and we call this box the form thumbnail. And by default, you can see that we display the name of the person who created the form and the creation date and time just beneath that. Now, it is possible to display a third piece of information, but by default, nothing is selected. So we can adjust the settings to display, for example, a date field, a piece of text, or a category field. And the way that we do this is via the template settings. So if we click on Edit Template, we can see we've got the editor open. If we click across to Settings and scroll down to the very bottom, you can see that we have this button or the setting that says Display on Thumbnail. And by default, nothing is selected. But if I open up that drop down, you can see that we can choose from a number of fields that we have on our template. So we can see date of shift, which is this one up the top. We've got the shift, which is this one here. We've got location, etc. Now, only a special few fields can actually be selected here. Those are text fields, which have been set to be single line text. So we don't do multi-line or pre-filled, only single line. And we do dates and we do category fields. And this way, the information will be kept quite short, which is the whole purpose of displaying the information on the form thumbnail. We want to keep the information quite short. So I'll show you what I mean. If I select the category field that we have for shift, which is this field that we have here, you'll see that we've got day in yellow and night in blue. And if I save this setting that I've just changed, if I save that, you can now see that on each of our form thumbnails, we have that category field displayed. So that can make it easier to find certain, in this case, it's easier to identify which forms relate to which shifts. And we can change that again. So we can change it if we want to display the, let's say the location. So this field that we have here, this single line text field, save those changes, and we can see what zone each of these forms relates to. So we can customize that based on text fields, date fields, and category fields. Now, the second setting that I want to show you in this video is the form sorting. So what I mean by this is the order in which we display these forms. At the moment, they're all displayed on Tuesday, the 7th of May, because they were all created on Tuesday, the 7th of May. You can see that the creation date is the same. However, the information that is inputted on each of these forms in the date field that we have on there is different. So if I toggle from timeline to register, you can see that for the date of shift field that we have on our template, the information entered on each of those is different. We've got the 29th of April through to the 3rd of May. And we might want to display all of our forms based on the information inputted onto our form, the date inputted on the form, and not the creation date. And we can adjust that as well. So the way that we do that, if we click on Edit Template, we go to Settings, and then down the bottom here we have Sort Forms By. By default, you can see it's creation date, but we can also choose our other date field, which is the date of shift. And we know that it's this field because if I change the name, if we just change it back to date, you can see that if I type in anything, it's consistent here. So we always know what we select on this list, which field that corresponds with. And let's say we want to order everything by this date here. If I now save those settings, you can see that instead of all lining up on the 7th of May, they're now ordered by the date entered on the form. So from the 29th of April through to the 3rd of May. And this is probably more useful because on each of the form thumbnails, we can always see the creation date anyway. So you can see that they all still say the 7th of May, but they're ordered day by day. And this setting also applies to the way that the analytics charts display the information. So if we were recording a quantity of, let's say, man hours on each of these days. And this one was 20, this one was 10, this one was 10, this one was 20, this one was 10, etc. When we head across to our analytics charts, if we wanted to plot that information, it would show up that on the 3rd of May, we had 10, on the 2nd of May, we had 20, on the 1st of May, we had 10, etc. However, if we change that setting back to creation date, it would show that on the 7th of May, we had all of those added up together. So maybe it was like 50 or 60 man hours. It would all show up on the 7th of May. And that might not be truly accurate. But just something to be aware of, the ordering of the forms, as you see them here, will be reflected in your analytics charts as well. Just something to be aware of. Now, the other thing to keep in mind is that any settings that you adjust on the website for this template, any of those form thumbnail or form sorting settings that you adjust, those will apply instantly across the mobile app as well. So everything will look consistent between your computer and your phone. And it will affect everyone who has access to this template. So everyone will be viewing the forms in the same order. Everyone will see the same information on the thumbnail. If you change it, everyone will see the same changes. So just something to be aware of. It keeps it nice and consistent across everyone within your team. So if you need help, you can always access our suite of help articles up here. We've got an article for every possible action and aspect of Dashpivot stored in here. But if you can't find what you're looking for, we've always got our live chat as well. So you can send me a message or someone else in the team and ask us what you're looking for. But that's how you can adjust the template settings to customize the form thumbnail and the form sorting and change the way that the forms are displayed and sorted inside of Dashpivot. So I hope that that's been useful, and thanks for watching.